Hey, you guys, what's up? So today we are playing as a rhino in the Play as Dino mod. And the rhino is so, it's just so slow. It's ridiculous. Like, look at this. This right here is just boring. This is just do, 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 do. Like, that's the soundtrack for this guy. That's his theme song right there. There's a couple creatures in the Play as Dino mod that were recently added to be playable. So we're going to try out a couple of those. I'm going to take the rhino, I think, to the redwood biome is what I'm going to try and get him to. And we're just going to see what's up. I don't think I can make a nest as him yet or anything like that. No, you can't make a nest. You can't really do much. The rhino is female, too. But I mean, yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to try and level him up a bit, see what it's going to be like playing as a rhino, at least, and see what goes from there. Now, in the Play as Dino mod, obviously, it's not the Ark version and the freaking stamina, guys. I didn't realize the stamina went down so fast. I can just barely get to a full charge for a couple seconds before I run out of stamina completely and stop. A supply drop. But in the official release of Ark Primal Survival, which this mod is probably the closest emulation you can get to that, unless like you go to other dinosaur games, which would be like The Isle, which is you play as a creature too in that game. If you don't know about it, I do have gameplay videos about it you can check out if you want. But I'm just questioning exactly what each creature will be able to do and how fun it's going to be, because like, I don't know if the different creatures are going to get like different things they can do. I don't know like if they're going to be able to build certain things like that would be realistic and not like freaking walls and stuff. I mean, I don't see you when you compare Ark to a game like The Isle. And you look at the gameplay involved and you look at the way you play the game and the way stamina drains in The Isle versus Ark. And then food and hunger, food and water and your health and stuff compared to The Isle. I feel The Isle would be a better experience. In my opinion, this is just my opinion. You guys might share a different opinion, obviously. Let me know if you do. Direwolf! No! Don't start biting my ass! No! Come on! Let me shit. I'm never gonna get away. Hey, come on. Oh yeah, hell yeah, you can't even hit us now. Yeah, that's right. You see that? This is how you do it. This is how you do it. Yeah, he can't even hit us now, I don't think. No, he hasn't even hit us. Hell yeah. We're safe. That's overpowered as shit. But that's my opinion, obviously. Oh, damn it. No, don't kill me. No. Come on, let me go. Shit. What? Wow, I basically imploded. And now it's gonna eat my body. Cool. All right, well, let's respawn and then we'll get on the topic again. All right, so we're back again as the rhino. Unfortunately, we got our ass handed to us. The worst thing is, too, I think about playing as this guy. Oh, God, please don't be stuck. Please. Oh, okay, all right, he's not stuck. I find the worst thing playing about this guy is, one, it is so incredibly slow. And two, if something starts attacking you from behind, I mean, you can't turn and hit it. You have to hope you can back up fast enough so you don't die from whatever's attacking you. And you're able to attack back with your freaking horns. So that's a really big drawback, because this guy really doesn't have a turn radius that's good at all. Like, this turn radius is not good unless you're charging, and you can only charge for so long. But anyways, back on the topic of Primal Survival and The Isle and stuff. And when I add the games to comparison, God, I should not be crossing this. I would feel that, well, it could be a bias too, because I'm more familiar playing as a creature in The Isle versus Ark. But it could be a much different experience, and I don't know if it's one that I would enjoy quite as much. Like, I imagine Ark is gonna have like making nests and making your own packs and stuff like that, so that's gonna be different, obviously. Like, you're gonna be able to have like a direwolf pack and raise your own and stuff like that, whereas The Isle, I mean, you're really just a dinosaur that runs around and kills everything trying to make itself stronger versus make a family and make all of that stuff. But that's the way I see it anyways, as far as playing as a creature. I don't know. I think it would come down to The Isle for me personally. That means I'm still gonna play the shit out of Primal Survival. I know for a fact I am. I'm probably gonna love that game, because Ark itself is a very good game. I'm very confident that Studio Wildcard is going to deliver a game that is going to be really good. I think it's going to be on a similar level to Ark for those people that like to play as creatures. I should not be going through a jungle. But well, let me. I'm saying all this now because I want to hear from you guys, and I want to hear your opinion on the matter, because that's what really matters to me. Like, I can put my opinion out and spark the discussion, but it's you guys that really make the discussion. So I want to hear from you guys. Let me know what you think about ARK and the whole primal survival thing. Do you think it's stupid? Do you like the idea? Are you super hyped for it? Do you play the Isle and you want to, like, play the ARK one more? Do you think ARK is going to do it better? Do you think ARK is going to do a better, man? I just gored the shit out of that guy. And stuff like that. Just let me know. I'm gonna make my way to the Redwood biome now. And we're gonna hang out there for a little bit. And then I'm going to play as another creature. All right, so here we are at the Redwood biome. I'm just taking a look around. I really haven't been in this biome too often. As you guys know, if you watch my ARK videos religiously, you know I've only been in the Redwood biome once since its release. And I do think it's a beautiful biome. I love the idea of it. Look at that, like... This is kind of cool. I would imagine. Can I fit down through this? If I can fit down through this as a rhino. No, I can't fit down through it. Oh, that sucks. That sucks. I want to be able to go down there as a rhino. That'd be kind of cool. But yeah, you guys know that I haven't been in this biome very much at all. And I'm really not liking this rhino right now because it's so freaking slow and your stamina is so dependent on different things. I have a level up. I've killed quite a few things as I've been here. Wow, that trike didn't even stand a chance. I'm just wondering what the mod developer is going to add for this rhino and like what the gameplay is going to be like once it can actually do the things. Like, are they even going to continue this mod once ARK Primal Survival comes out? Like, is it still going to be a thing? There's bugs behind me. There's bugs behind me. I had bugs kill me already once. I don't want to die again. God, that was bad. Bugs in this game, when they get on a rhino, it is bad. Like, oh God, let me freaking run. Go, 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 go. Boom. Oh God, that's comical. Are they still following me? No, they're not following me anymore. All right, we're good. Ow, oh shit, they're right behind me. Go. Go! Go! Oh, shit. This is bad. There we go. Oh my God, there's so many of these fuckers. Why can't I run like... I just want to run free. That's all I want to do. I want to run free. There, now I can turn and I can face them. God, bugs are like... They're so horrible because like they... Oh God, the turn radius is so bad for this rhino. Ugh. Get lost. But yeah, like anything gets behind you, man, like you are dead as a rhino. You have to be super careful about that because it's going to get bad for you in a really hurt. It's going to be so fast. What the hell? Where the hell did you come from? Oh shit. They're jumping down off the thing. Oh no. Oh no. Ugh. He didn't even see that coming. That's funny. That's great. Oh, you're right in the path. Boom. Oh, right through you. Like, you didn't even stand a chance. Oh, shit. Get out of my way. You ruined my charge against the Tyrannosaurus Rex. All right, let's get this Rex. Let's get this Rex. We're going to charge him. Apparently, I'm not going to charge him. I'm not allowed to charge him, apparently. Look at the terror birds. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you want to go? You want to go, good sir? Do you want to do this? You can't handle the rhino. You can't handle any of this. Yeah, that's right. Kill everything. Oh my God, the rhino's charge is so incredibly powerful. It's ridiculous. This guy can't hurt me. I know that because he's a pansy when it comes to attacking and whatnot. The freaking terror bird is vicious. Like, it doesn't even care. There we go, you're dead now. Anyways, we're gonna go and we're gonna play as something else now, cause the rhino, well, it's really freaking strong. I'm actually really happy with this guy. Boom! Oh, look at that, you almost died one hit. You almost got rocked. But yeah, we're gonna play as something else now because, well, yeah. All right, so we're back again, and obviously we are playing as the Sarco. I never really noticed how its body curves when it walks. I never noticed that before. It's kind of cool. But yeah, we're playing as the Sarco because this guy was also just added in. I didn't even notice the spikes it had on its snout. That's cool as hell. Funny story. I was watching a documentary on these guys. It was about the habits of crocodiles or alligators or something. I don't know. Maybe you guys would know about it. Odds are you guys know about this stuff because you guys are smart as shit when it comes to this. Watching a documentary, and these, apparently there's large gators or something, whatever they are, crocodiles, alligators, one of the two, because I know they're a different type of gator. But anyways, The Megalodon's gonna come after me. You wanna do this, bro? You wanna do this? We got this. No, you're gonna go down. But anyways, I'm going off track. I'm gonna get up on land because I'm gonna get away from that guy. I don't want anything to do with him. There's different types, and obviously the biggest ones are the leaders. They're the quote-unquote boss of whatever section of lake that they are in. And this one smaller one challenged the larger one, and it, like, did a death roll while it was in its mouth, and it ripped its top jaw off. Like, the smaller one had its top jaw, like, completely ripped off, which was cool as shit. Not cool for the creature. I mean, that had to suck, but I thought it was cool that, like, you know, it was one of the things that happened in nature. Now, I would imagine being in the swamp is the best place for this guy to be, so I'm going to move him to the swamp, and we're gonna do all that. I can't do anything really as the alligator either, or the sarco, whatever. There was the Dinosuchus or something like that, and this guy can't break trees at all or get around them apparently, so I'm just gonna find a way around this myself. Come on, you got this, bud, you got this. But yeah, there was another creature. It was a Dinosuchus or something. I'm probably saying that wrong, but it was like, I don't know if it was related to crocodiles or alligators, but apparently it was completely different from this guy here, the sarco. I have questions about this. I was wondering from you guys, let me know. I'm not gonna fit through here, am I? Oh my god, I actually fit through there. Wow, my fat ass actually fit through that. I am impressed. I am really impressed. My question for you guys was that other alligator, crocodile, whatever, what was it first off? Was it related to alligators or crocodiles? And, was it bigger than this guy right here, the, sarco? Was it bigger than it? Was it more threatening? Did it have a harder bite? Let me know, some facts about that thing, because I want to know about it. It's coming to the Isle really soon, and, I know I've made a lot of references to the Isle, but, it just so happens that it's a creature going to that game. Alright, so I took the Riverway up because it was super fast to get to the swamp. Wow, this guy can move super fast in the swamp. Whoa, you just like flew through the air. Super fast in the swamp, and I can see why you guys wanted to see the sarco in water against other creatures, because apparently— Ow! What the hell is that? What is that? Is that a piranha? Something bad just attacked me. I'm gonna get out of the water and get on land. Now, I can see why you guys wanted to see a battle of this guy being in the water instead, because he's probably far more effective in the water. Something I was going to bring up a while ago, I had a comment, and I had meant to bring this up many videos ago, but I didn't because I kept on forgetting about it. When I get recording, I mean, I'm basically in a whole different mindset. I'm not thinking about much other than the game at the time. So I'm trying to be a little bit more in depth with this one, as you could probably tell. I had a comment, and it was someone complained that I had been making references and comments about creatures and dinosaurs, but I was not an expert in any of it, really. And, like, I'm not that up to date when it comes to creatures like dinosaurs or anything like that. I'm really not, and I'm not the best source to go to for information on creatures. When it comes to this game, when it comes to Ark and stuff like that, I like to think I'm fairly knowledgeable in the game, except for certain things that I don't keep up with, like updates and stuff like that, which I probably should keep up on top of some of the updates. But I mean, every YouTuber has their flaw. But someone said that I shouldn't be saying things about dinosaurs if I'm not an expert or I don't know 100% for sure. But I make it pretty clear in my videos that, you know, if I don't know something, I will tell you guys, like 110%, I will tell you guys at all times, like, if this might not be fact, I don't know for sure, and then I'll ask you guys, because usually one of you guys watching guaranteed will know, whether it be a fact about a creature or it be something about the game. I know you guys have my back when it comes to that, because you guys are very smart when it comes to this stuff. I think, I'm not saying this to be like, oh, my subscribers, praise them, God. I'm not saying it for this. I'm saying it because I genuinely believe this. You guys are incredibly smart when it comes to this game and facts about creatures, and that's something that I take a lot of pride in this community we have, because you guys are always teaching me stuff and telling me stuff, and like, there's so much that you guys teach me in each video that, like, I can't retain all that knowledge. So, like, you guys will repeat it again and try and make sure that I know it. Wow, that was really weird. My tail just went flying, but it's something that I'm very appreciative of. It's an alpha raptor. Don't hurt me. Back away slowly. Back away slowly. Don't. Why the hell are you moving forward? Okay, let's get out of there. Let's get out of this, because we don't want anything to do with that guy. Hello, Mr. Sarco. We got away from the Alpha Raptor because it wanted to hurt us. Were you chasing after? Are you gonna attack me? Oh, you don't want to do that, dude. You don't want to do that. You don't want to go after that raptor. Oh, okay. I thought he was gonna go out. Oh, shit. Don't want anything to do with that. But yeah, someone made that comment, and I think I make it pretty clear that I'm not an expert in this stuff, and I do go to you guys for help. Like, someone made a point that, a lot of YouTubers don't even listen to their audience when they come up with things, and if they're wrong, they don't care. Like, they won't take that as an experience to learn, and they won't take the constructive criticism. Now, I face a lot of criticism on YouTube because I'm still not... I know I'm not the best content creator out there. I probably never will be, and that's something I accept because I'm perfectly fine with where I am on YouTube with the audience that I have. When it comes to learning from the audience, I take every chance I can. I'm getting out of that swamp because that was dangerous as hell. When it comes to learning from the audience, I think that I'm really open-minded to it. I think I do a decent job of listening to you guys and just learning, and it's why I ask frequent questions and stuff like that, because I want to learn. I know I have the opportunity to learn, and I know it's opening the opportunity for others to learn. As far as other content creators and me and not taking criticism and stuff like that, I think I take it fairly well. I know other content creators do take it well too, but I mean, obviously there are some that don't take it at all and they think they're perfect, but I know for a fact I'm not perfect on YouTube. No one is perfect on YouTube. Not even some of the best YouTubers that are at the top of the subscriber list and stuff like that. But I just wanted to throw this in here. Sorry if it got a little bit boring, but it's just something I wanted to say, just because it's just something that I've been thinking about a little bit. So, I mean, you know, thank you guys for sticking around and, you know, teaching me so much stuff, because you guys have taught me so much. And if there's anything I could take away from this channel at the end of the day, it's that it's a learning experience for me, and I'm having fun doing it. But anyways, enough about that. We're going to go ahead. I think we're going to play as like the Eurypterid or something, or like the Manta or something, because that's something else that was added to one of the updates. This update was like 15 days ago. I am so behind on this update. I should have kept up to date on this, but we're going to go ahead now and do that, because the Sarco, I mean, you can't really make a nest with it. I don't know where you would lay eggs. I don't know where any of it would be. You'd probably lay eggs like in a... You'd probably dig a hole somewhere in the sand, I think, and lay eggs there or something like that. That's probably what would happen, and maybe like guard it all day or something. I'm not sure how these guys reproduced. Anyways, let's move to the next creature. And here is the Eurypterid, I think. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right, but either way, this guy can't sprint. It can't really move fast at all, which kind of sucks. But I mean, the attack's kind of cool. This guy gives me the creeps, though. I mean, look at that. That gives me the creeps as hell. Now, I know these things... Can this thing come out of water? I think it can come out of water. Yeah, see, It's really buggy. It can actually sprint on land. That doesn't really make much sense to me. Can it sprint? I wonder if I can sprint now that I go on water. No, I can't sprint. Right click obviously does nothing. This guy doesn't really have many attacks. I mean, not even C. Can't really do anything. There's no alternate attacks with this guy. It seems like it's really basic in this mod right now. Can't sprint unless these things can't sprint at all anyways. Are those legs? I think this thing has legs. I see like these little stick things. Either way, let's go down to the deepest depths of the ocean and see what we can do down there. I do know these guys are supposed to be fairly deep in the water, so we're just gonna go down there. Unfortunately, we can't swim. We can't like super speed and all that fun stuff because, well, apparently this guy doesn't like to move fast. He likes to be lazy. I wish I could use my tail. I wish like the tail was some aspect or some in some way, shape, or form usable. What's the stat? Okay, 160 health. We really don't have much of anything to go off of right here, because I mean 160 health isn't very much at all. I think Mega Piranhas have like 100 or something like that. Wow. And then obviously you can't make a nest or anything. I don't even know how these guys would have reproduced. I have no idea at all. I don't think I'd want to know, actually, because that's a scary prospect to see these things. Oh god, that's a whole other avenue of just wow. All right, well, let's get down here, see if we can hunt a couple things, and yeah. And here we are all the way down here. I got a couple levels while I was making my way down here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to boost... Oh, okay, I only got one level, apparently. I boosted my movement speed a little bit because, well, this guy is still really slow. We have a Megalodon, I think, coming up on us right now. Is he going to attack us? Come on, bud. You don't want to attack me. I will ruin you. I think I can knock this guy out, actually, because this guy has like some kind of poison or something. I don't know what this guy would make me. Maybe he would have eaten like fish or something. Small fish and stuff like that. I have no idea what this guy would have eaten. I was watching a documentary a while ago on the Megalodon, that guy right there. And yeah, I've been watching a lot of documentaries lately, trying to get up to date a little bit with some of the information that I have, because of the comment that I had a while ago. But I was watching a documentary, and this guy had shown the megalodon tooth, and the megalodon's tooth was incredibly big compared to today's great white shark. Like, it was incredible to see how big this guy's tooth was compared to a normal great white shark. Like, you look at a great white shark tooth, and it's like, oh my god, that thing's massive. You look at this thing, it's like the size of your freaking, it's like the size of your hand, like, it's crazy. Oh, that's right, I'm hitting you now, you got trouble, don't you? Yeah, I wish I could move faster, but I can't really... Are you not going to attack me? Like, you don't want anything to do with me? Or I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to end the video right here because I can't really do much as this guy. I'm going to keep up to date with the next update that comes out for breeding and stuff like that. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you smash the crap out of that like button. Every single like helps this channel a ton, and I appreciate it a ton. If you guys have any questions or comments, or you want to answer one of my questions that I answered in this video, well, then let me know anything in the comment section below, obviously. But once again, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next video.